lovely people of the internet. My name is Brianna, the Breathing Canvas, and today I'm going to show you my comic book pop art look. So let's take a look at the sketch. So there's going to be all these dots on the face. And the thing with this is you don't want it to be like too big or like too close together, whatever, because otherwise it's going to look like chicken pox or acne. Everything else is pretty much just going to be lines and big bold colors. You want to make sure that the lines like aren't too thin or too thick in certain places. Think about it as how the artist who drew the comic books, how they drew these characters and made them. So there's a lot of like little thin strokes and everything. On the dots, that's just, you know, from the way that it was printed and everything, like how we see pixels. So let's get started. So first I'm going to take this lip pencil. I like this one because it's kind of rosy, it's not this bright red, so it'll help, you know, so it doesn't look like a chickpox kind of chickpox. It's such a weird word to say, chickpox. I feel like it should be chickspox. You can use like a Q-tip if you just take the cotton ball part off, or you can use a little dowel stick or whatever you can like dip into the makeup that you want to use. But since I have this, it's pretty convenient for me. I'm just doing little dots here all the way down. I'm trying to make this as straight as possible. So just make sure you have like your foundation on the way you normally would do it and everything. I know that these dots are kind of faint, but I actually want that because the idea is that the way that the comic books are printed, it's kind of printed with the like off color. It's like really close to what the color of the face was supposed to be. So like if the face was kind of like this pale peachy pink, the dots would be like maybe like a slightly darker pink or something. So it's in the same family. So I'm trying to do a mix between like the same color as my skin and kind of what it would be like if it was in a comic book, and also so that it can be seen. I tried, you know, with the possibility of using like a darker brown, but it didn't really pop. That's your pun of the day. Actually, no, I have another one. No, that was the only one, I think. I was thinking of it before, so don't worry, I didn't like plan it, like, oh, I got a pun for them. No, I don't try, they just happen. The pun gods are after me. Who am I kidding? I love puns. They're punny. They're really clever. I know some people are like, oh, they're so cheesy, like, but they're clever. You have to think about them. But most of the time, they just come to me. The puns are whispering in my ear, waiting to be told, and the groans will be heard, and the pun gods will be pleased. Yes, that was a good pun, Brianna. Good. We have another one for you. Next up, we're going to do the eyebrows. I'm going to be using brown instead of what would in the comic book be black because it just looks a little bit more natural, even though none of what we're doing is natural. Just to help blend in with everything else because I'm not changing the color of my hair or anything. I just feel like the eyebrows with them would just pop out too much. So I'm just gonna use a brown eye pencil and just kind of trace around. This is gonna be pretty bold because pop art is bold, and I'm gonna take a brush, just kind of feather that and smooth it just a little bit. I'm gonna use my cream and a paint brush to do lines. Just emphasize this nose here just a little bit. Another thing to keep note of is that this is all about perspective. It's about whatever you want to profile, because different angles is going to look different. So for me, I'm going to do this side because this is my real good side. Like, say you got good sides. This is my good side. This is my real good side. So I'm going to start from this brow and kind of go in. This is going to make it pretty thick because also in comic books, they do like a little bit of like shadows. Like on the page, what's gonna be farther away, it's gonna be a lot of like dark. Like sometimes even this is like two or three tones darker than this. Just to give the impression like they're by like, you know, a window and the way the light's hitting. Actually, it's really cool that, you know, put all that detail into it to kind of give an idea of the environment that the characters are in. Be selective with what you want to do because if you do everything, it's just going to be a little bit too much. And also, if you are going for like a certain like character that's in like a certain emotional state, like, you know, you see a lot of the ones that are like, you know, really concerned and they have like, you know, the little like lines up here, or they have like the teardrop, or you know, maybe the smile lines. That's all up to you. So what I'm doing is kind of just like, you know, swiping off and just kind of letting my brush kind of glide gradually off so that it has that kind of, it's like feathering out, so it isn't just like a bold stop here. Because that's how the artist would have drawn the comic book character. But you still want these to be bold, like don't be faint lines. Make it thick, but also have that fade element to it. Well, I'm gonna do some blue eyeshadow to really make those eyes pop. I'm sorry. Because that was kind of iconic. A lot of people like the blue, just the big, bold colors. So we're gonna do blue here, just all over this bottom lid. And then this was a little tricky thing. So if I was to draw this, like on the sketch, you know, you draw the crease right here, but it's already there. So what we're gonna do is kind of go just a little bit above it. This one, I'm gonna try going just a little bit closer actually to where that crease is. Yeah, so you see the difference here. It's kind of hidden here, and here it's pretty obvious. But again, the idea is that it's supposed to be obvious because it is a drawing. Everything here is painted on and obvious. And also, if you're not too sure about this and everything, like with the space, what you can do is just blend your eyeshadow up so that isn't just this white space. I'm gonna take my liquid eyeliner because that's really good at making thick strokes. I'm gonna do a big cat eye because that's, again, the style of the time period, and they're really into like the big lashes and eyes and everything. Okay, now we're gonna go on to lips, which is gonna be really fun because we get to add in all of like the lighting and the little lines and everything. So I'm gonna take my white crayon and I'm gonna do a little. Actually, you can, if you have good lighting and everything, you can see where the light naturally hits. For me, there's this little shimmer right here, so I'm just gonna trace that. Kind of make it a little bigger, kind of in the middle here, on one side, and let it taper off. And again, careful not to go too much because then it'll start to make like a light pink, and then you just want this to be really bold, so don't stay here too long, keep adding onto it. I'm gonna do another one on this side here, just to kind of like balance it in a way. So I'm gonna take a black eyeshadow and kind of go in the inner corners of the bottom lip to kind of help with like those big bold lines, because if I were to draw like a little sketch of it, and when I drew it, I did kind of the shadow of the upper lip on the bottom, and I did a little bit of that, so that's what I'm gonna do. Then I'm gonna take a pencil and go all the way around like I would a lip liner. Because if I was to, when I draw my sketch, you know, you draw the lips and like kind of the main features all in like black, so it's, you know, obvious it's there. So that's what we're gonna do on the face now. My sketch is coming to life! And again, this is another choice that's up to you. Depending on the artist, some like to do the lips like really like pointed and in and kind of like curving out that way. Others like to make it nice and round, or you could do kind of like a fill in, like a little triangle here. All up to you. I'm gonna do a little bit of both just so you can see it here. So that's not exactly what I meant by a triangle. I just meant like kind of like fill in the corner here, make it just a little bit of point, but it's okay. I'm gonna just do a few lines, just picking out from the lines on my lips, and just kind of going over that with thin lines here. It's not too thick, but just thick enough so that it can be seen. And I forgot mascara. Actually, no. We are doing fake eyelashes today. And not just adding fake eyelashes.
Big eyelashes.
So before I get into actually doing the eyelashes, I'm just gonna do a few strokes here. I'm gonna pull my skin so it's nice and taut. So this is a good example of when bold is too much. So this is kind of nice and thin but clumpy. This just looks like a spider. So now I'm gonna take beige. And you want to do just a real thin line so it doesn't glob up. If you want to like just even like draw a little bit of it onto your thumb so that you don't get an overload onto your lash here, and then just kind of swipe it in there. You're gonna lie it on just on top of your actual lash line here. Hold it down for 30 seconds. Alright lovelies, and that's it. So this is gonna be kind of a wrap up for my superhero series, at least for now. because that's all that I really had planned and designed. However, if you have a super however, if you have a favorite superhero or supervillain that you haven't seen me done, words! Type it down in the comments below, let me know. Then next up, I'm actually gonna be doing a few different series that I have and just putting it all in together so that you guys have a variety of everything. So all of that I've planned for you, I'm excited to show it to you guys. So yeah, thank you so much for watching. Click on that thumbs up button down below, lets me know that you like this video and that you wanna see more things like this. And I will see you next time, lovelies, bye bye.